Good morning.
Good morning.
We invite you to please join in singing the entrance hymn found in your order of worship, "Here I Am, Lord."
Follow Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with each of you. My brothers and sisters, gathering this morning, asking for healing for ourselves, of body, soul, and spirit, we also ask the Lord's, in this penitential rite, for forgiveness, pardon, and mercy, that we may also be persons of forgiveness and pardon to one another. Lord Jesus, you raise each of us to new life and promise your mercy and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, for the gifts of the change of seasons, may you wisely practice stewardship with regard to your gifts of creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, for your wonderful gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit, we give you thanks. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, life of all that is mortal, and joy of the saints, we humbly pray to you for our brothers and sisters, that freed from the bonds of mortality, they may possess your kingdom in everlasting glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds covers the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you, your sons from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
of salvation according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him, assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since you shall become a ruler, who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage.' After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way." The Gospel of the Lord. Since we celebrated Christmas in the manifestation of the Lord, we've also celebrated on the Sundays the solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God, then the great feast of the Epiphany. I'd just like to spend a few moments talking about, very interesting, the whole theme of the manifestation of the Lord Jesus. There was a book written in 1895 by Henry Van Dyke. The book was called The Other Wise Men. You might remember that in Scripture, there's different interpretations. One, like this morning, talked about the Magi going to offer their gifts to the Christ child. Others talk about the three wise men. Others, indeed, talk about various titles, not only Magi and the three kings, but indeed the saviors, indeed, giving thanks to God. When Artaban Rand, indeed, wrote his book, it's very interesting. The fourth wise man was another man. He was, indeed, we hear three names for the wise man or the Magi. One was Caspar, one was Melchior, and one was Balthasar. And why we think of the three wise men or three Magi or three kings was simply for the fact that they brought three gifts, the three gifts present. But Artaban was a fourth wise man, and they were all going to join together, but Artaban got separated. He got lost, indeed, so the other Magi took off to find the Christ child. In Jerusalem, they thought he was born in Bethlehem. And so when Artaban got there, very interesting, they already had left. He was late. And what happened was, they very interesting, indeed, took some things. They took, indeed, Artaban had sold his house before he began his journey. And he got three precious jewels, a sapphire, a ruby, and a pearl. And so when he got to the place where there was to meet up with the other magi, they had left. And he had to get a caravan together of camels and guides and supplies and food for the journey. And so he did. But to get them, very interesting, he had to sell and give away in payment for the supplies his sapphire. And so he did. He bought all of the supplies for the journey. And so he set out. And you might remember, Herod was not a very good man. As a matter of fact, he was a very evil man. Herod killed his own wife, killed his oldest son, who would inherit the kingdom, killed two other sons, killed a number of the leaders, indeed, of his area, especially those in politics and had power. He was ruthless in his murder of them. And so Artaban got to, eventually, Bethlehem. You can remember the word that was put out when Herod found out the Magi were going to look for the birth of Christ Jesus. And so he gave them, he told them. So Artaban got to Bethlehem, and he was always late. Herod had sent out to kill all children, all male children, 2 years and younger, in the vicinity of Bethlehem. And so they did. Artaban was staying at a couple's home who just had a newborn male child in the last few weeks. And so a corporal's guard went up to the house where he was staying with this couple and the newborn child. And he paid off the guard, the captain of this military guard, to send him on his way. He bribed him with, indeed, his ruby. And so the gift that he had for the Christ child was only the pearl left. And he continued to search for Christ all the days of his life. He indeed followed him to Egypt and then back to Nazareth and then his preaching missions of Christ for 3 years. He finally was to find Christ on the day that he had been condemned to be crucified. Artaban was in Jerusalem. Remember, in the temple, the great curtain was torn. And off the roof of the temple flew a tile that struck Artaban in the head. As he lay on the pavement, he saw a young woman running towards him and a corporal's guard following her. And very interesting, she was going to be sold into slavery because her father had not paid his debts. And so she was going to be sold into slavery to pay those debts. And Artaban, as he lay there in the street, indeed, gave his precious pearl away to pay for this girl's ransom and safety and security. And so we see Artaban always searching for the Christ, but always coming up late. As Artaban lay there, dying, bleeding profusely from the head, we hear a voice from heaven saying, "Indeed, Artaban, you are my son. You have taken care of people in need throughout this journey of life. Indeed, no, you have not found me, but I have found you. Come into the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." I'd ask you to think of your loved one you've gathered to remember this morning and how he or she indeed searched for Christ in their life, in their daily or weekly or monthly life, how they searched, the like Artaban searching for the Christ, the Savior of the world. So I ask you to reflect on that, not only today, but indeed for your, not only those who you're remembering this morning because of your love for them, but how we can follow the Christ in our daily and weekly and monthly, indeed, lives. 3 gifts that the Magi brought to the Christ child. They have very great significance in the mission and ministry of Christ, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I'd ask you to think, very interesting, of gold. Gold, even at the time of Christ, was considered the king of metals. And so it was very appropriate that one of the Magi brought gold to the King of Kings, to the King of People. I'd ask you to think of frankincense. Frankincense was used by the priest when he went into the temple in Jerusalem to offer sacrifices in the morning hours and evening of giving a lamb. And indeed, how Christ came as the King of Kings, the King of People. And then I'd ask you to think, indeed, of myrrh. Myrrh is used in the time of Christ for embalming people when they had died. So Christ came, very interesting, as our King, who was to die for all people. So please think, not only today, of your own loved one and what gifts they brought to you as a family member or a friend, maybe a son or a daughter, maybe a spouse, maybe indeed just a sister or brother. I'd ask you to think of them and how they brought the kiss of Christ, not only to our world, but to you as a loved one. You know, there's a saying that talks about the Lord should have chosen not Magi or three wise men, but three wise women. And very interesting, the three wise women would have stopped and asked for directions on how to find, indeed, Jerusalem and Bethlehem. They would have, very interesting, they would have, indeed, been on time. They would have brought cleaning supplies to clean the stable where Christ was born. They would have baked a casserole when they came. They would have helped, indeed, Mary deliver the Christ child. And they also would have brought disposable diapers. So I ask you to think and remember the gifts of the Magi, the gold, the frankincense, and myrrh. I ask you to think of Artemis, who searched diligently for Christ, how your loved one did, and indeed how they searched, and they brought gifts to you for their life in Christ Jesus. We hear and we know that Jesus came, very interesting, into the world to live for people, and in the end, to die for people. Christ Jesus was the true King, the perfect High Priest, and the supreme Savior of all people. Let us remember in this Memorial Mass, indeed, how our loved ones touched our lives with their gifts.
Loving and gracious God, as we celebrate your love for us, as you welcome home our loved ones who have died into your heavenly kingdom, we offer these prayers and petitions.
Our response to the petitions will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For all the deceased whom we gather to remember today, who in baptism were given the pledge of eternal life, may they now share all the joys of heaven, we pray to the Lord. For all the sick and suffering, and for those who care for them, that they may be filled daily with courage and hope, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of our dearly departed who seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief and mourning, we pray to the Lord. For peace in our families and around the world, we pray to the Lord. May God's blessings shower us with a bright, healthy, and peaceful new year. We pray to the Lord.
Loving and gracious God, we
give you thanks for the gift of our loved ones we remember this morning. We ask you to welcome them into your heavenly presence in eternal life. We give you thanks for their life and ask for our own good health through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join in singing the offertory hymn, Blessed Are They.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Give the Lord's sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, in your kindness, the sacrificial offerings we make for our departed brothers and sisters, and for all who sleep in Christ, that, set free from the bonds of death by the singular sacrifice, they may merit eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up our hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Amen.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In Christ, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
indeed are holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, and our Bishop Emeritus Matthew, and all the clergy, religious, and faithful throughout the world. In each Mass we celebrate, we come to the commemoration of those who have died and entered into eternal life. In your program this morning, you'll notice two pages of those who have died between November the 16th and December the 15th. So we ask you, as we participate now in the commemoration of those who have died and entered into eternal life, to mention the name of the person you've gathered to remember.
Rosa Gennaro.
Remember our brothers and sisters whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away from our eyes every tear. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Now let us share a sign of Christ's love and hope for one another. For communion this morning, we'll have two lines coming up the center aisle. Go back to your seats by the side aisle. For those who are in our balcony this morning, we'll have communion brought to you by Eucharistic Minister.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we participate in the divine mysteries, we pray, Almighty God, that they may advance our salvation and bring pardon to the souls of our brothers and sisters, for whom we implore your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
May
Almighty God bless each of us, keep us in the Lord's continued good health and holiness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Just a very few announcements. The first one is that you are most cordially invited to attend this Memorial Mass on the third Saturday of each month at 8:30. So you're most cordially invited to attend this Mass. Second of all, on behalf of myself and you, we'd like to thank very much Don Camille, our organist and soloist, Christine, one of our lectors, as well as Steve, our video photographer. This was also broadcast into people's homes and computers who tuned in. Keith Bach, our lector and member of the board. Alex, who is a person who did all the setup for the chairs and so forth. So we'd like to thank all of them on behalf of all of ourselves for their work and the action. Go